Okay, to repeat again, this one is a field current. So field current will be generated by the field source. And please be reminded that this is the DC, and we have DC source which come into the field circuit. So IF will be forward bias all the time. Meanwhile, we have here the rotating shaft on the EA. Rotating shaft will generate internal generated voltage, and at the end, it will measure at your terminal and terminal voltage or phase at the phase. Okay, so the listed are the factors that affected why we cannot, we are not able to measure or obtain the voltage that generated at the internal generated source or shaft here or air gap here at the terminal due to the drop, voltage drop due to the impedance or the synchronous impedance. Okay, if we took take a look further into the concept of the basic equivalent circuit of the generator circuit for the armature side of the system or the circuit, we shall have a output three phase, and with a, due to the factor of number one that we mentioned before, the armature reaction, the output voltage on the phase will measure as the amount of EA minus the voltage drop, and V of EA is the amount of V phase plus V across your armature and armature inductance. If we put the V phase to the left here, so you can see that the amount of V phase is equal to internal generated voltage minus the voltage drop of the armature inductance elements there. Okay, then due to factor number two of the self inductance and stator impedance, actually stator impedance. So just now the V phase is affected due to the drop at your armature JX, but now it's due to the stator resistance and self inductance and stator resistance here will contribute to the stator impedance. Stator impedance. So just now only JX I armature. Now you have to include another JX the reactance of the self inductance and also the stator resistance. Means the longer the coil, the higher the internal the resistance of the coil. If you have a wider coil and the wire is wider, so the resistance will be lower. Right? But if the wire is long wires, so you shall have a higher inductance and also higher in terms of resistance. Okay, if you combine the armature reaction effect and the self inductance in the machine, so called the combination of both two axes here will be synchronous reactance. So we just combine them together. We face will become internal generated voltage minus synchronous reactance minus also the stator resistance. Okay, here are the three phase output. We have single input of field to the rotor, and we have three output: phase one, phase two, phase three, or red, yellow, blue, and all are delivering three phase output to the system. So this is equivalent circuit. EA is differ from V phase by resistive and inductive voltage drop. Resistive and inductive voltage drop. So you will not get the same element or same value over here at this terminal voltage or terminal point with the drop of the these two element impedance here. So XS is a synchronous reactance which contribute by the self inductance and also armature reactance. So ZS is the synchronous impedance. When you combine XS and the series resistance, become synchronous impedance. So if we look, take a look at the per phase equivalent circuit of the synchronous generator, so V phase will become, or you can write EA is equal to I across your JXS here, plus IR here, plus V phase here, or you rearrange V phase to be in front, so V phase will become I EA minus JXS IA minus RA IA. So this is voltage drop due to the resistance, voltage drop due to the reactance. Okay, here are the VF. Actually, VF is equal to, V drop here is equal to I that come across the impedance of the field element. By right, if at DC, so the amount of inductance usually will become zero. That means that the inductance will become a short circuit. So the only impedance or resistance that occur here or exists here is only the element of R. Okay, we'll take a look at that one later on the exercise side. Okay, let's say we have a for three phase generator or three phase motor, we shall have three kind of elements which have three same element which combine or construct into two kind of construction, either in Y, you can see here Y, or either in delta, and Y or delta. So if the machine is Y connected or star connected, the voltage across the AC line, V line here, is equal to third-three of the voltage across the phase winding. You can see that the phase winding and the phase winding, actually the voltage across this phase winding is lower compared to the voltage that we should measure on the terminal or line to line voltage. You can see means that the V terminal here is third-three of V phase, and V terminal is third-three of V phase. Meanwhile, the current that flows into the line and also the phase back to the another line is the same current. So I line is equal to I phase. Meanwhile, V terminal is bigger than V phase by third-three. Okay. If you take a look at the, that's why I told you you have to draw the diagram or the illustration to assist your understanding, compared or rather than you just remember or just hafal or remark or just memorize the equation. So better you draw and draw the illustration so you can see or you can comprehend better. Okay, if it is in delta connected, so the line voltage, you can see that the line voltage is just the same like the phase voltage, and the voltage across your line is just the same like voltage across your phase. So V phase and V terminal and V line is same, but in terms of current, you can see that the current that flows from the system to the line or from the line to the system will be separated into two branch. Here we have two branch, here also we have two branch. So two branch combined into one, two branch combined into one. Okay, means that the current, the amount of current that go into the line is the combination between the two phase here. So I line is equal to combination of I phase by the number of or the multiplying of third-three. And just now, third-three for voltage. Now third-three for current. So this is for delta. Okay, this is the voltage regulation phasor diagram part. So the voltage in synchronous generator AC voltage in synchronous generator or AC voltage. And so this generated voltage is a AC. So you should represent in phasor, means that you have to know at certain point what are the degrees of the voltage. So phasor diagram is to show the relationship between your voltage with other element of internal generated voltage, phase voltage, impedance, reactance, current, and so on. So we know at certain point or certain time or duration or period, what are the representing voltage or current or other element compared to the 0 degree or reference. Okay, usually we take V phase as a reference. It means that V phase we put at 0 reference, 0 degree. We have 0 to 360 degree or 0 to 100 degree. Okay, we take V phase as a reference. So at unity power factor means that it just supplying resistive load. So the phasor diagram of a synchronous generator with a unity power factor usually we come like this. So we have V phase at 0 degree and the current will follow or will be in phase with voltage. This is voltage, phase voltage. The current for resistive load will be usually in phase, so in line. So let's say we have here impedance. So the EA will be JXSIA will be perpendicular, mean 90 degrees of your current. Of your current. So if you supply at unity power factor, so the phasor diagram will be like this one. Let's say we have a lagging power factor, means that we have a inductive element. So we have a lagging power factor. The current will be in the negative or lagging. It follows your voltage at certain degrees. So let's say we have this certain degrees of following voltage currents. So for JXIA, the reactance of it will become 90 degree with the current, 90 degree here, up here. So if you shift to the end of your node here, so it become EA will become lower, become lower due to the lagging power factor of your current. So this is delta is your load angle. Load angle will be reduced compared to here. Load angle is bigger. Low angle will be reduced. Let's say you have a leading power factor. Leading means your current will lead your voltage. This is your voltage. Current is positive. This one is negative. This one is positive. So leading and perpendicular to your current, you have a element of impedance here. Reactance here. So the EA will be much higher lah. So delta load angle will be much higher. So in term of your voltage regulation, and we have learned before in term of generator, we should consider the performance in term of voltage generation. The narrow the range, so the better or the good. The better the performance of the generator lah. By right, if motor, we shall consider in term of speed regulation. In term of, we compare when we run at no load compared to full load, how much the difference will be. So the variation between which measure in the terminal of your machine or your system, we represent the voltage regulation of your system. So means that we measured at no load how much the voltage output is. Then when we put a full load, means that we take in the highest current that the machine can supply or the generator can supply, how much the voltage drop. And we minus that two amount, divide by the full load voltage level times 100%. That's the voltage regulation of your generator. Okay, the effect of the load voltage regulation of the voltage regulation due to the type of loads. If you have a lagging load, means the inductive loads, so the lagging will be significantly can be seen lah. The terminal voltage will decrease drastically. We put a inductive load, so we can see that the terminal voltage will drastically drop. If we put unity power factor, means that the only the resistive load like we put a box of the incandescent filament lamp, so the voltage drop will be much lesser. It will drop but not so significant as we put in the red